everyone. Today we are going to discuss the chapter 1, that is matter in our surroundings. What is matter? Everything in this universe is made up of material called matter. Now what are the properties of matter? See, matter is anything which occupies space and have mass. Each matter is a collection of lots of small or tiny particles. Particles of matter are continuously moving. Physical nature of matter. Particles of matter are very tiny and the particles of matter have space between them. Particles of matter are continuously moving and the particles of matter attract each other. See, the particles of matter are very tiny. For explaining this, we will do one activity. Take a beaker and fill it with 100 ml of water. Now put few crystals of potassium permanganate. After putting the crystals of potassium permanganate, you will get a purple color. Now separate the 10 ml from the beaker and put this 10 ml into another 100 ml water of beaker. Now separate the 10 ml from the same beaker and put this separate 10 ml solution in another 100 ml water of beaker. Now separate the 10 ml again and put it into another beaker. If you will see, then you will get this color is very dark in the first beaker and very light is in the last beaker. Why? Because the quantity of particles is continuously going to decrease. That's why the color is dark in the first beaker and lighter in the last beaker. So we can speak that particles of matter are very small and each and every matter is made up of very small particles. Now particles of matter have space between them. How we can speak this? See, in this case, take a beaker and measure the level of the beaker after putting water. Now put some sugar or salt in the beaker. Mix well and after mixing again measure the level. You will get the level of water does not change. Why? Because the particles of salt get into the space between the particles of water. That's why we can speak the particles of matter have a space between them. Particles of matter are continuously moving. How we can speak? For this we will do one activity. Take a beaker filled with water and put some ink, whether it is red or blue. Now leave the beaker undisturbed for few hours. What you will get? You will see the color of the whole water is unique or constant. Means after some time you will get the same color of the water. Why? Because the particles of ink or particles of water are continuously moving. And what this process is known as? This process is known as diffusion. So what is the definition of diffusion? The intermixing of two or more different types of matter on their own is known as diffusion. Next, particle of matter attract each other. For this, we will do one activity. Take an iron nail, a piece of chalk and a rubber band. Now try to break them by hammering, by cutting or stretching. It is more easier to break the chalk and less easier to break the rubber band and very difficult to break the iron. Why? Because the particles in the iron nail are closely tied together with the force which is known as force of attraction. And this force is less in rubber band and less in chalk. That's why it is very difficult to break the iron nail. Next, matter around us exists mainly in the three states, that are solid, liquid and gases. Now we will see what are the properties of all three states. See, the solid state. What are the properties of solid state? Solid have definite shape and fixed volume, and the space between the particle is minimum, and force of attraction between the particle is maximum. Space is minimum, that's why force is maximum. The movement of the particle is minimum, force is maximum, that's why particle can't move here and there. They are least compressible, we can't compress solid. And the rate of diffusion is least. Force is maximum, that's why particles cannot move here and there. That's why the rate of diffusion is very less. Now, properties of liquid. Liquid have no definite shape but have fixed volume. And liquids take the shape of the container. The space between the particles is intermediate, and the force of attraction between the particle is also intermediate. Intermediate means less comparative to solids. Next, the movement of the particle is intermediate. They are less compressible, and their rate of diffusion is more than that of solids. Now, properties of gases. See, gases have no definite shape or fixed volume. Gases occupy the whole space of the container. The space between the particles is maximum, and the force of attraction between the particle is minimum. Space is maximum, that's why force is minimum. The movement of the particle is maximum. Force is minimum, that's why particles have ability to move fastly. They are most compressible, and their rate of diffusion is more in gases comparative to solids and liquids. Now, change of state. See, what is the change of state? If we are increasing the temperature or if we are decreasing the temperature, that time states will change. How? When a solid is heated, it changes into liquid, and when a liquid is heated, it changes into gas. Now, when a gas is cooled, it changes to liquid, and when a liquid is cooled, it changes into solid. For example, if we will heat ice, then that ice changes into water, and if we will heat water, then that water will change into steam. Now, if we will cool the steam, then that steam will change into water, and if water is cooled, then it changes into ice. See, we can remember this thing via this graphical diagram. When we will heat the solid, that time solid will convert into liquid, and when we will heat the liquid, that time that liquid will convert into gas. Now, if we will cool the gas, that time gas will convert into liquid, and if again we will cool the liquid, then this liquid will convert into solid state. Next, melting or fusion. See, when a solid is heated, the particles begin to vibrate with a greater speed and begin to move more freely than at a particular temperature. So, the solid melts and changes into liquid. And the process of melting is known as fusion. Now, the temperature at which a solid melts is called its melting point. The melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin. Now, what is latent heat of fusion? See, the amount of heat energy required to change 1 kilogram of a solid into liquid at atmospheric pressure, at its melting point is called its latent heat of fusion. Now, what is boiling? See, when a liquid is heated, its particles begin to move very fast, and then at a particular temperature, the liquid begins to boil and changes into gas or vapor. This boiling is a bulk phenomenon. When a liquid boils, the bulk of liquid changes into vapor. Now, the temperature at which a liquid starts boiling is called its boiling point. The boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius, or in Kelvin it is 373. Now, if you will add 273 in this 100 degrees Celsius, that time this 100 degrees Celsius will convert into 373 Kelvin. What is the latent heat of vaporization? The amount of heat energy required to change 1 kilogram of liquid into gas at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is called the latent heat of vaporization. Effects of temperature on molecular motion. See, if we will heat the solid, that time the space between the solids becomes maximum and particles will start to vibrate or they will start to move. In the case of liquid, if we will heat the liquid, that time the space between the liquid particles will increase and particles will start to move very fastly. Next is sublimation. See, what is this sublimation? According to change of state, first solid will convert into liquid, then into gases. But this is different in the case of sublimation. So, what is the definition of sublimation? The change of state directly from solid to gas or from gas to solid is called sublimation. If a solid camphor or ammonium chloride is heated, it changes into water vapor, and if the vapor are cooled, then it changes into solid. These sublime products will not come in the liquid state. If solid sublime product is there, that will convert directly into vapor, and if a vaporized sublime product is there, that will convert directly into solid. We can explain this via this process or via this diagram. See, in this diagram, this is a china dish. So take a china dish and put some ammonium chloride in the dish. Now keep the funnel in the inverted manner over the china dish and seal the upper part of the funnel with cotton as well as with any cork. Now heat the content. If you will heat the content, that time this ammonium chloride will convert into vapor form, and when these vapor will come in the contact of the wall of the funnel, that time that vapors become solidified. And because of this cotton plug as well as because of this core, these vapors will not go in the atmosphere. And by sticking on the wall of the funnel, it will become solidified. So like this we can speak. Then in sublimation process, solid will change into gas or gas will change into solid. Now, this is an interconversion of the three states of matter. If you will heat the solid, that solid will convert into liquid, and this is known as fusion. If you will cool the liquid, then liquid will convert into solid, and this is known as solidification. Now, if you will heat the liquid, then liquid will convert into gas. This is known as vaporization. If you will cool the gas, then gas will convert into liquid. It is known as condensation. If you will heat the solid, then that solid will convert into gas. And if you will cool the gas, then that gas will convert into solid. This process is known as sublimation. Now, effects of the pressure on gases. When a pressure is applied on the gas, the particles come close and the gas changes into liquid. We can liquefy the gas by applying pressure and reducing the temperature. A compressed solid carbon dioxide is called a dry ice. If a pressure is reduced, it changes directly into gas without coming into liquid state. So, solid carbon dioxide is known as dry gas. Now, what is evaporation? The change of a liquid into vapor at any temperature below its boiling point is known as evaporation. Evaporation is a surface phenomena. Particles from the surface gain energy and overcome the force of attraction and changes into vapor state. What are the factors affecting evaporation? See, the rate of evaporation depends on the surface area, temperature, humidity, and wind speed. Increasing the surface area increases the rate of evaporation. If you will increase the temperature, then rate of evaporation will also increase. If you will increase the humidity, then the rate of evaporation will decrease. If you will increase the wind speed, that time rate of evaporation will also be increased. Evaporation causes cooling. When a liquid evaporates, the particles of liquid absorb some heat from the surrounding and evaporates. So, the surrounding becomes cool. For example, we can speak, people sprinkle water on the roof or open ground because during evaporation, water absorbs heat and make the hot surface cool. And during summer, we sweat more because during evaporation, the sweat absorbs heat from our body and making the body cool. And wearing cotton clothes in summer keeps us cool because cotton absorbs sweat, and when the sweat evaporates, it absorbs heat from our body and makes our body cool. So, dear children, this is the description of the chapter 1, that is matter in our surroundings. Thank you.